Hello students, today I am going to take the chapter Strategies for Enhancement in Food Production, second module. In the last module, I discussed different breeding methods in animals, different management practices like dairy farm management, poultry farm management, apiculture and fisheries, and also I discussed the different steps of plant breeding. Today, let us start with the objectives of plant breeding. The main objectives include to increase the yield of desired plant products such as grains, fodder, fibers, oils, etc. To increase the qualities of the crop with regard to size, color, shape, taste, nutrient contents, milling, keeping and cooking, etc. of grains, vegetables, flowers and fruits. To produce varieties that are resistant to fungal, bacterial and viral diseases, also resistant to insects and pests. To change the duration of crop maturation according to need, that we can either reduce or prolong the period of maturation. To obtain particular varieties for particular agroclimatic region, to change the growth habit of crops as needed, to produce new varieties for new seasons and new areas, to eliminate the toxic substances in consumable parts to make them safe for human consumption. There are some crops that contain some toxic substances. For example, cassari seeds have a neurotoxin. So, to eliminating such toxins will be favorable to our society. Now, what is crop improvement? The principal aim of the plant breeding is to produce some improved plant varieties. It is achieved by different methods, like selection, hybridization, plant introduction, acclimatization, mutation breeding, breeding for disease resistance and insect resistance, selection of somaclonal variants, genetic engineering, etc. Let us discuss what is selection. In selection, good quality plants are selected. Basically, there are two types of selection, natural selection and artificial selection. In natural selection, that works according to Darwin's theory of natural selection. That means suitable and most fit varieties selected and others eliminated. In artificial selection, it is the selection of certain individuals from a mixed population. And artificial selection includes mass selection, pure line selection and clonal selection. In mass selection, plants with the superior traits selected from the fields either during harvesting or after harvesting, and the mixture of seeds so obtained is called mass, hence the name mass selection. In pure line selection, groups of plants obtained from single homozygous and self-fertilized plants are selected. It is a method of crop improvement in self-pollinated plants. Now, what is clonal selection? Selection and propagation of best individuals of clones from a mixed population of vegetatively propagated crops. Clones, you know, clones are plants generated through vegetative propagation that are morphologically and genetically similar. Let us move to hybridization. Hybridization methods also help in crop improvement programs. In hybridization, it is a method of producing new crop varieties by crossing two genetically different parents. I discussed its basic steps in the last class. Now, depends on the parents selected for crossing, different types of hybridizations are there. In intervarietal hybridization, here cross occurs between different varieties of the same species. In intravarietal hybridization, cross occurs between the same varieties. In interspecific or intrageneric hybridization, cross occurs between different species of the same genus. Same genus, hence the name intrageneric hybridization. In intergeneric hybridization, cross between plants of different genera. Now, when coming to plant introduction and acclimatization, these are also help to improve the crops. In plant introduction, it is the process of introduction of plants from their growing locality to another with the changed climatic conditions. Acclimatization, that means the adaptation of introduced or transferred plant in the changed or new climatic condition. In introduction, there is a definite procedure for introducing a plant material from abroad. Strict plant protection and quarantine laws have been made by different countries. Let us see some examples of plant introductions. Maize, potato, groundnut, chilies, coffee, rubber, guava, grapes, papaya, cashew nut, lychee, bougainvillea, aster, etc. are introductions. Now, mutation breeding, it also a method to improve the crops. Induction of mutation in plants with the help of mutagenic agents and their utilization for the production of superior varieties. Hugo de Vries was the first person who defined mutation as sudden phenotypic changes which are heritable. Mutation is a process by which genetic variations are created through changes in the base sequence within genes, and that results in the creation of new character or trait that are not found in the parental type. Mutations are spontaneous as well as induced. Mutations can be induced by certain mutagens or mutagenic agents. Mutagens are of two types. Some of the physical mutagens are X-rays, beta rays, gamma rays, as well as UV rays. Chemical mutagens include nitrous acid, malic hydroxide, hydrazine, methyl methane sulfonate, ethyl methane sulfonate, etc. These mutations are generally harmful and recessive. 1 in 1,000 or more may be useful. Some crop varieties produced through mutations are the following. In wheat, Sharbati Sonora, Pusa Lerma. In rice, Remy, Atomita 2. In barley, Erectoids Erectiferum. Castor, Aruna is a crop developed through mutation breeding. Now, plant breeding for disease resistance. What is disease resistance? It is the ability to prevent the pathogen from causing the disease and is determined by the genetic constitution of the host plant. These diseases are caused by fungal, bacterial, and viral pathogens. These diseases may cause sometimes 20 to 30% crop loss or sometimes even total. Let us see some common diseases. First of all, common fungal diseases. Brown rust of wheat, red rot of sugarcane, late blight of potato. In brown rust of wheat, it is caused by Vaccinia recondita. Now, red rot of sugarcane, that is caused by the fungus Calitotrichum falcatum. Late blight of potato is caused by the fungus phytophthora infestans. Now, some common bacterial diseases are black rot of cruciferous, citrus canker, red stripe of sugarcane. Black rot of cruciferous is caused by Pseudomonas cambestris. In cabbage, you can see the black rot. Citrus canker is caused by Pseudomonas citri. A citrus infected with citrus canker can be seen in this picture. Now, red stripe of sugar cane is caused by the bacterium Acidovirax avinae. Now, let us see some common viral diseases. Tobacco mosaic, tomato mosaic, cucumber mosaic. Tobacco mosaic is caused by tobacco mosaic virus. Tomato mosaic is caused by tomato mosaic virus. Cucumber mosaic caused by cucumber mosaic virus. When considering about breeding and development of cultivars resistant to disease, that always helps to enhance the food production. And also, it helps to reduce the dependence on fungicides and bactericides. And breeding is based on the causative organism and the mode of transmission. A disease-resistant variety can be produced by different methods. The methods include conventional methods of breeding, mutation breeding, selection among somaclonal variants, and genetic engineering. And conventional breeding steps are, here the transfer of resistant gene as achieved by sexual hybridization between the target and the source plant, followed by selection. The basic steps are the following. The first step is the screening germplasm for resistant sources, then hybridization of selected parents, then selection and evaluation of hybrids, and finally testing and release of new variety. Here you can see some crop varieties bred by hybridization and selection for disease resistance. First, in wheat, Himagiri is a disease resistant variety that shows resistance to leaf and stipe rust and hill bun. Wheat rust are caused by three species of fungal genus Puccinia, that is, stipe rust by Puccinia stipeformis, leaf rust by Puccinia triticina, and stem rust by Puccinia graminis, and hill bun by Tillacia caris and Tillaria foetida. Brassica, a disease resistant variety, is Pusa suvarnae, that is resistant to white rust. And this white rust is caused by a fungus Albugo candida. You can see the picture of white rust. In cauliflower, here you can see two disease resistant varieties. One is Pusa subra and the other is Pusa snowball K1. That is resistant to black rot and curl and blight black rot. This black rot in cauliflower is caused by Pseudomonas cambestris, a bacteria. Cowpea, another disease resistant variety you can see here, that is Pusa comal. That is resistant to bacterial blight. And bacterial blight in cowpea is caused by Pseudomonas axinopodis. Now, Pusa sadabahar is a variety of chili that shows resistant to chili mosaic virus, tobacco mosaic virus, and leaf curl. Here you can see another crop variety that is produced by conventional breeding. That is Parbani Kranti. It is developed by transferring a resistant gene from a wild variety of Abelmoscus esculentus. And these conventional breeding methods is often constrained by the availability of limited number of disease resistant genes. So, in mung bean, resistance to yellow mosaic virus and powdery mildew were induced by mutations. Now, next topic is insect resistance in plants. This insect resistance depends on some morphological and biochemical or physiological characters. Some of the morphological characters are listed here, that is hairy leaves that makes plants resistant to jassids in cotton and cereal leaf beetle in wheat. Solid stem is another morphological character that gives resistance to sawfly in wheat. Smooth leaves and nectarless cotton varieties also gives resistance. Here it gives resistance to boll worms in cotton. Biochemical or physiological characters include high aspartic acid, low nitrogen and sugar content in maize, and these characters give resistance to stem borers in maize. Now let us see some crop varieties bred by hybridization and selection for insect pest resistance. Peecs Gaurav is a variety of brassica that shows resistance to aphids. Now, Peecs M2 and Peecs M3 are the variety of flat bean that shows resistance to aphids and fruit borer. Now, Peecs Avani and Peecs A4 are varieties of okra or bindi that shows resistance to shoot and fruit borer. Now, let us go to the next topic, plant breeding for improved food quality. This plant breeding for improved food quality is very essential, as 840 million people in the world do not have adequate food to meet their daily food and nutritional requirements. Apart from this, 3 million people suffer from micronutrient, protein and vitamin deficiencies. Sometimes diet lacking essential micronutrients, particularly iron, vitamin A, iodine and zinc, increase the risk for disease and reduce lifespan and reduce the mental abilities. And breeding for improved food quality is known as biofortification. It means breeding crops with higher levels of vitamins, minerals or higher protein and healthier fats. What are its objectives? To improve protein content and quality, to improve the oil content and quality, to improve the vitamin content, and to improve the micronutrient and mineral content. This biofortification can be produced by conventional breeding and genetic engineering. In conventional breeding, the steps include first the screening germplasm for nutrient-rich crops, then cross-hybridization of this nutrient-rich varieties with high-yielding varieties, and then selection of recombinants with extra nutrients. Conventional breeding for producing biofortified crops is quicker, cheaper and less controversial than genetically engineered crops. Golden rice is an example of a genetically modified crop developed for its nutritional value. It is a variety of Oryza sativa produced through genetic engineering to biosynthesize beta carotene, a precursor of vitamin A. Here you can compare a golden rice with a normal rice. Now let us study some biofortified crops. Maize hybrids are there with twice the amount of lysine and tryptophan. High protein wheat variety is the Atlas 66. There are iron fortified rice varieties having 5 times iron compared to the existing varieties. There are vitamin A enriched vegetables like carrot, spinach and pumpkin. Also, vitamin C enriched vegetables like bitter gourd, bathua, mustard and tomato. Also, there are calcium enriched vegetables like spinach and betuwe. And protein enriched beans, broad, lablab, French and garden peas are also available. Now let us go to the next topic, single cell protein. One of the alternate source of protein for animal and human nutrition is the single cell protein. Here, microbes are being grown on an industrial scale as a source of good protein. One of the advantages of this is microbes like spirulina can be easily grow on materials like wastewater from potato processing plants, straw, molasses, animal manure, and even sewage. Thus, incidentally, it helps to reduce environmental pollution. Here you can see some examples for single cell protein like spirulina, nutritional yeast, spirulina tablets. And this single cell protein production is faster and cheaper. Let us compare with the production of normal food. 250 kilogram of cow produces 200 gram of protein per day. But 250 gram of microorganism like Methylophilus methylotropus expected to produce 25 tons of protein. It shows rapid succession of generations, takes less time for the production. Algae takes only 2 to 6 hours. Yeast takes 1 to 3 hours. Some bacteria takes 0.5 to 2 hours. And another advantage is genetic modification is very easy. And apart from this, single cell protein contain high protein content, that is 43% to 85% in dry mass. Another advantage of this single cell protein production is we can use broad spectrum of original raw material for its production that also includes waste products. Also, we can produce single cell protein in continuous cultures that not dependent on climate. And easy regulation of environmental factors is possible. And algal culture that is possible even in space, so not competing for land. An example is chlorella. Let us study some more examples for single cell proteins. In algae, Chlorella pyrenoidosa, Senidesmus acutus, Spirulina maxima. Bacteria, Bacillus megatherium, Pseudomonas species. Actinomycetes, another type of bacteria, here Nocardia species, Thermomonospora fusca. Fungi, in yeast, Candida lipolytica, Saccharomyces cerevisiae. In fungi molds, Aspergillus niger, Trichoderma viridae. In fungi, mushrooms are also considered as single cell protein. That include Agaricus campestris, Morchella crassipus. Now, let us go to the next topic, tissue culture. It is one of the latest and promising methods of crop improvement. This tissue culture is based on the totipotent nature of the plant cell or the phenomenon of totipotency. Now, what is totipotency? It is the inherent ability of a plant cell to develop into a complete plant. This concept of totipotency was first developed by Haberlandt. In tissue culture, we use single cells or groups of cells taken in culture, and that plant part with a single cell or group of cells taken for culture is known as explant. Sometimes in culture, we get an undifferentiated mass of cells when culturing explants. That undifferentiated mass of cells are known as callus. These callus by culture can generate roots and shoots by the supply of hormones into the medium. For the development of roots and shoots, auxin and cytokinin are required. And that development of roots and shoots from callus culture, that is known as organogenesis. In tissue culture, there are some basic conditions required. One is the tissue culture laboratory. That should consist of washing and storage facilities, media preparation room, and a transfer area. A tissue culture medium is the most important one in tissue culture experiments. The media composition and preparation is very important. The media should contain the basic materials like inorganic minerals that include macronutrients and micronutrients, growth hormones like auxin, cytokinin, gibberellin, etc., vitamins, vitamins B1, B6, B12, C, etc., some amino acids like aspartic acid, glutamic acid, some amides like aspargine, glutamine, etc., solidifying agents. Mostly in tissue culture, agar is used as a solidifying agent as it is inactive to other components in the medium. And a pH is required, that is normally between 5 to 6. In tissue culture, maintenance of aseptic environment is very essential. So, sterilization of glassware, instruments, culture room, transfer area, nutrient media, etc. should be done. Let us study the tissue culture basic steps. First thing is the preparation of suitable nutrient media. Then selection of explants. Then sterilization of explants. Then inoculation or transfer. The explant is transferred into the media in an aseptic environment. And these explants are incubated, and incubation is done at a particular environmental condition, that is 25 plus or minus 2 degrees Celsius, 50 to 60% relative humidity, and 16 hours of photo period. After that, regeneration of plantlets take place. Then the process of hardening. Here the plant is exposed to normal atmospheric conditions. Finally, the plantlet transfer. In plantlet transfer, we are transferring the plants into the field or in the greenhouse. Now, what are the applications of tissue culture? Micropropagation, haploid production, production of disease-free plants, culture of rare hybrids, protoplast culture, somatic hybridization, genetic engineering, somaclonal variations, nucellus culture, etc. are some of the applications. Let us see one by one. In micropropagation, it is a rapid vegetative multiplication of valuable plant material for agriculture, horticulture, and forestry using shoot meristem culture. And this propagation through tissue culture is also called micropropagation. Next is the haploid production. The most important method of haploid production is the pollen culture. Sometimes ovule culture also can be practiced. Here you can see the haploid production. Microspores are haploid, so their culture generates embryos and that develop into plantlets. These plantlets, these haploid plantlets, after colchicine treatment can produce diploid plants. And these diploid plants are fertile and pure lines and can be used for plant breeding. Production of disease-free plants, one of the important applications of tissue culture. For producing disease-free plants, shoot apical meristem is commonly used as it is free of viruses. A shoot apical meristem can be seen in this picture. Culture of rare hybrids is very important application of tissue culture. For this, embryo culture is commonly practiced. Sometimes hybridization with different species or different genera may not be fertile. So, we can excise the embryo from the flowers and cultured. Here you can see the picture of a naked embryo excised from a flower. Protoplast culture is another important application of tissue culture. There are two important uses for protoplast culture. One is somatic hybridization and other is genetic engineering. In somatic hybridization, we are culturing the protoplasts of two different plants. Here you can see the picture. When the protoplast is fused, here forms a binucleate cell that is called heterokaryon. And this heterokaryon later fused to form the hybrid. Here you can see the formation of hybrid, but here you can see the formation of cybrid. Here the nuclei is not fused, cytoplasm only fused. So it is a process of cybridization that develops into a cybrid. But this is the development of a hybrid. Here you can see what are the steps of somatic hybridization. The first step is isolating single cells from plants. Then you have to remove the cell wall. That can be either mechanically or by using enzymes. Pectinase and cellulose are the common enzymes used to remove the cell wall. Now this protoplast is allowed to fuse electrically or by using PEG, polyethylene glycol. So now binucleate cells are obtained that are known as heterokaryon. Later the nuclei fused to obtain the somatic hybrid. Another application of protoplast culture is in the genetic engineering. Due to fragile nature of protoplast, certain bacteria or portions of DNA or nitrogen fixing genes, etc., can be easily incorporated by genetic engineering. So, we can produce genetically modified plants using protoplast culture. Tissue culture is of different types based on the plant material used. One is explant culture, then callus culture, root culture, shoot culture, suspension culture, anther and pollen culture, embryo culture and protoplast culture. Now the next topic is somatic embryogenesis. Somatic embryos are also called embryoids that are formed from somatic cells in culture. The somatic embryogenesis can be initiated in two ways, either by inducing embryogenic cells within the preformed callus or directly from pre-embryonic determined cell which are ready to differentiate into embryoids. Here you can see the formation of embryoid. First explant is taken, the explant is cultured in nutrient media, then callus is produced. From the callus, some of the cells develop into embryoids and these embryoids develop into embryo and finally the plantlet. Now what is soma clonal variation? It is also related with tissue culture. plants produced through tissue cultures, that is from callus cultures, have been found to have considerable variability or variations, known as somaclonal variations. The variations which are stable and have some agronomic characters, example pest and disease resistance, are useful. These variations may be genotypic or phenotypic. And typical genetic alterations include changes in chromosome number, chromosome structure, DNA sequence, etc. Here you can see the somaclonal variant of a plant. Let us go to the questions. The first question, part of the plant used for tissue culture. Options are callus, stalk, scion, explant, embryoid. The plant part that is used for tissue culture is known as explant, and depending on the explant, tissue culture is of different types like shoe tip culture, anther culture, embryo culture, etc. The option D is the correct answer, that is explant. Now the next question, white rust of brassica is caused by. Options are fungi, bacteria, virus, aphids and nematode. White rust of brassica is caused by albugo candida. It is a fungus. Now the answer is option A, fungi. Now the third question, plant breeding for developing disease resistance is done in the variety. Options A, Peecs Savani, B, Peecs Swarnim, C, Peecs A4, D, Peecs Gaurav, E, Peecs Sem2. Peecs Swarnim is a brassica variety that is resistant to white rust. Now the answer is option B, Peecs Swarnim. Now the question number 4, PEG is used in. Options A, somatic hybridization, B, tissue culture, C, mutation breeding, D, artificial hybridization, E, SEP production. You know somatic hybridization, here naked protoplasts of two different varieties, species or genera can be made to undergo fusion by electric fusion or chemofusion through sodium nitrate or polyethylene glycol. This PEG is a chemical that helps to fuse the protoplast. So the answer option A, somatic hybridization. Now next question, embryoids are A, non-zygotic or somatic embryo like structures, B, non-zygotic or somatic embryo-like structures which are produced in vitro which have the ability to form complete plants. C, zygotic embryos formed in vitro which have the ability to form complete plants. D, zygotic embryos formed not having the ability to form complete plants. E, zygotic embryos formed in vivo and have the ability to form plants. Embryoids are non-zygotic or somatic embryo-like structures which are produced in vitro culture and have the ability to form complete plants. The process is called somatic embryogenesis. Now the option is, correct answer is option B, that is non-zygotic or somatic embryo-like structures which are produced in vitro which have the ability to form complete plants. Now the next question, IARI, Indian Agricultural Research Institute, Peecs, is situated in the state of. Options A, New Delhi, B, Maharashtra, C, Bihar, D, Andhra Pradesh, E, Gujarat. The answer is IARI regional station is located in Peecs, Bihar, in the state of Bihar. So the correct answer is option C, Bihar. Now, the next question. Biofortification led to the production of hybrids that had twice the amount of lysine and tryptophan in options A, wheat, B, rice, C, carrot, D, maize, E, peas. In 2000, maize hybrids that had twice the amount of amino acids, lysine and tryptophan compared to the existing maize hybrids were developed. So, the correct answer is option D, maize. And now the question 8, Peucer shubhra and Peucer snowball K1 are varieties resistant to black rot and curl and blight black rot. The crop is options A, wheat, B, brassica, C, bindi, D, chili, E, cauliflower. These two varieties, Peucer shubhra and Peucer snowball K1 are cauliflower varieties that are resistant to black rot and curl and blight black rot diseases, and these diseases are caused by Pseudomonas cambestris. Now the answer is option E, cauliflower. Now the next question, select the mismatch from the following. A, soma clones, morphologically and genetically identical plants that are generated through tissue culture. Meristem culture is used to generate virus-free plants. Somatic hybrid, hybrids generated through artificial breeding. SCP can serve as food rich in protein, minerals and fats and carbohydrates and vitamins. And Atlas 66 generated through biofortification, which is the mismatch. Mismatch, somatic hybridization produces somatic hybrid and that are not generated by artificial breeding. Here in somatic hybridization, isolate a protoplast from two varieties of plants, each having a desirable character, can be fused to get hybrid protoplast and which can be further grown to form the new plant. So, the correct answer is option C, somatic hybrids, hybrids generated through artificial breeding. It is the mismatch. Now, the last question, common diseases and their pathogens are given below. Black rot of crucifers, red rot of sugarcane, brown rust of wheat, tobacco mosaic. And the next column, organisms, Calitotrichum falcatum, B, Pseudomonas cambestris, C, tobacco mosaic virus, D, Puccinia recondita. Select the correct match. Here, black rot of crucifers is caused by Pseudomonas cambestris. So, one will be B. And red rot of sugarcane is caused by Calitotrichum falcatum. Then 2 will be A. And brown rust of wheat is caused by Puccinia recondita. So 3 matching with D. And tobacco mosaic is caused by tobacco mosaic virus. So 4 matching with C. So the correct answer is option D. Thank you.